Hello, Nader here. Welcome back to Path of Exile. We are playing in the Best Sierra League as a solo self-found Spectral Shield Throw Juggernaut. And today we're gonna run the tier 3 cage map for the unlock. It's got the Zana's prefix, so modifiers apply to energy as well. So we got a nice amount of content rarity. And I rolled the Giants suffix, so monsters will also have increased area of effect. So should be a lot of fun. Hello there, currency drop. So based on the slave pens, and this one should have a boss based on just a car Casticus, according to the wiki. So that's of course the guys whose eyes we had to rip out in the story. So maybe he wants some payback? We'll see. Fighting balls, we already have those. See, so level 70 area, so the simple steel nets still work here. Let's see, I got some exploding corpses, so well, that's gonna be hilarious here. Got a by stream of monsters, pack of magic monsters. Okay. So you know what, we'll just head over that way. We'll put a totem there, open it, step aside, call out. And then we'll just shoot at it from a slight distance. Wait, oh, backstabbing. You monster. Okay, that looks profitable. Of course, no, these are maps, so getting more higher tier things than just whetstones would of course be appreciated, but well, shouldn't grumble too much about what you get. And we had a fight on top, so that's also fun. So I wonder if this one, just like the one in the campaign, also loops around. That would be fun. Of course, that one is difficult to backtrack. If this one also shares that property, then it's one of those maps that you really just need to clear as you go. But so far, no, we couldn't go back from the start. And all we have gone is just go forward. With minimal backtracking, there's a doorway there, right? Yeah, so let's see if there's some stuff to the side here. Because it could be that it's just one large room that just closes up. And indeed it is. So, oh, relatively linear so far with just some larger rooms in it. We have something. Ivorici, yes, a world's laziest assassin.
You there, a moment of your time.
Keep the target on low life. Okay, so Flame Golem, you're now dismissed. Keep the target alive. Yeah, minions didn't say anything about that. So let's first take out the minions. It's good that he's just smashing the ground from a distance. And I hope I did not murder him with the life regen, because this could get tricky. What about the bleeding? Well, actually bleeding at some point it stops, of course. That's good. Only lasts for 5 seconds. I mean, if this would be some kind of amped up Viper Strike build with poison that lasts for 15 seconds, then maybe it would have been a bit more difficult. But no, bleeding, it does stop after 5 seconds. Especially because I am stacking multiple layers. Hey, another Peregrine helmet. I'm stacking multiple layers of bleeding on top of each other. So of course that means that they also expire individually. So the shield I threw to take out the mage in the end is the one that expired last, but it also means that's why now the bleeding slowed down over time. Now for each missions, they are with a build like this that actually has very fine control over the damage that you deal. For each missions are no issue. if you're playing with a build which does not have control over the damage, like, say, a summoner, things get more dicey. Ooh, hello. I think this was a little too enthusiastic from all of you. Solid elemental damage, right? It's discharge does do a lot of damage. And I think there's already a cage over there. So it's more like a like an 8 or an infinity sign in how it loops. Ooh, hello. Hey, beastie with elemental thorns. Well, I'll grab you. I have you.
You have been captured, beast. You will be a survivor, or you will be fooled.
Also, why did I pick up that one? It's nice if you're playing with large two-handers, then of course you want a top end, but if you don't, then, well, why am I bothering to pick him up? Because you can put two items or even three items in the same space. Okay, yellow BC up ahead. And it is the one over there. Okay, at least it has a bit more life from the looks of it. So we can actually just go relatively full out. And then we throw it and then wrap it up. Are those blood dancers? They might be blood dancers. The blood dance, yes. So, boatload of decks, 20% movement speed, increased movement speed, preferency charge, reduced attack and cast speed, preferency charge, life regen per preferency charge, 21% chance to gain a preferency charge on kill, so that's effectively a nearly full blood rage built in by default. Increased damage preferency charge with hit against enemies on low life. Okay. So kind of fun. Not entirely a match, because, well, frenzy, no, I don't focus extremely on it, but via the blood rage, I do get it. This would make the frenzy charges much more reliable. Decrease in attack and movement speeds. Well, don't frenzy charges usually grant that attack speed, movement speed? Okay, so effectively that just gets neutralized. Actually, it gets reduced. That's normally 4%, so now it's 3%. Okay, fun. It's one of those nice to have items, but we'll see. Especially because the boots do provide us with a boatload of intelligence that we're kind of depending on. Oh, also Peregrine, that's ID that one. We have it. Is it better? 41% armor, everything else is fixed, and we get less. The one on the right is equipped, yeah, with cash gems. Also has more rarity, so it's just better all around. Okay, so we found the worst program. Yay. Well, onwards to more loot. And look at that, there's already a bunch of loot waiting. Things do get a little messed up if you pick up the oddly shaped sword things. Oh, hey, it's loot. You don't complain about loot. Not too much.
An orb of immense power.
And of course, now with the master missions, you always have a nearly endless appetite for just rare items to sell. To get more orbs of alteration, to buy more jeweler orbs, to turn into fuses. Ooh, something has been touched by a ghost. And oh look, you've been possessed by a ghost. Wow, we actually have a ghost that did its job. That is always good to see. End result, more loot. Ooh, fancy foils, now we have matching fancy foils. Okay, so again a nice matching wand there. Actually, we could put the currency there and it's still uneven. Okay. Wrap the boots, empty the pockets, and then we go towards the boss. Okay, excuse me for that. Still relatively early in the day. And now I'm recording this on the launch weekend of the Magic the Gathering Dominaria set. It's the pre-release weekend, so after I'm done recording this and uploading this, I'm actually heading out and play the pre-releases for the second time. So, and we've had a week of incredibly nice weather, so I've had a lot less recording time in than usual, but I'm still trying to just keep up an episode a day. But that does mean that I might end up recording at, no, some earlier in the day and under a little bit of time pressure. Wait, let's stop bleeding on me. But nope, everything is of course good. I heard the weather is getting a little less good in the upcoming week, so of course that means my schedule should be a little bit more back to normal. Let's take you guys out and then have some fun with the Jessica. Ooh, you made this into a nice cozy place, I see. Oh, there's some candles everywhere. Looks like you kind of spilled some candle wax over the statues. Not sure, quite sure if that was deliberate or not. Also, he's kind of not doing much. And we got a unidentified archive map for that, which is nice. Because I do like myself some unidentified maps. But we already did the arcade, so not gonna do it again. But I did, however, have another map lined up for you. So this one's gonna go into the map bin. So I'm gonna crank it up a notch. Unidentified Canyon map. Canyon is one of my favorites. It used to be a yellow map. Now, of course, it is not. We did do the cage, so it's now completed. And I think the canyon was somewhere over here. But it, of course, is now under the fog. But, well, Magic of Xana map missions, maps, rewards. So let's put in the canyon and see what comes out. So we have two beastie bosses at the end. I wonder if they could be caught or if they are too special for that. High amount of quantity and rarity, no visible auras, no resistance penalties, regen looks okay, armor looks okay, block looks okay. We'll see. We shall see what happens. So, lots of beasts. Not more beasts. Okay. Could be that it is all inhabited by beasties. Would be fun. Additional magic items revives nearby monsters with onslaught. Okay, so let's get my totem on. And then, oh, this is gonna be glorious. Okay, we can rule out beyond, I think, cause this for sure should have triggered something fun. Okay, so canyon is a mostly linear map. It's basically just a wide canyon. Who would have thought with that name? So it's tier, actually tier 4, so I need to move to the next tier of maps, so that's reinforced. Technically I could get away with using the slightly lower tier, but then I really need to just kill things exactly. Which often is not an issue, but I might as well just use the appropriate tool for the job.
This one is captured.
Because of course I'm not done yet with the tier 3s, so I've only unlocked 2 out of the 6 or 7 that are there. So I'm sure I'll have a use for the lower tier nets at some point in the future.
An orb of
ooh, hello
power.
There. So just keep waving from one side to the other. Hello, there's spiders. Hey, these are not beasties, so I guess the map is inhabited by beasties theory is kind of out the window. Could be that the enemies just have some extra tanky mod or something on them. Maybe elemental and chaos resists. Would be something, of course, now that they get, but I don't feel it. Oh, too late to capture. It was not a very special mod, though. Hey, something is cursing me. Hey, this one is a Nemesis mod. Could be that we get Nemesis as a modifier. That would be fun. I mean, Bloodlines, Nemesis, those are always great modifiers for maps, because, well, more higher tier mobs means, of course, more chance for higher tier map drops. Ooh, we got an Essence up ahead. I'm kind of feeling sorry for most of these melee mobs, since they rarely ever even have a chance of getting close to me. Oh. So we got a greedy dude. Greed was life. Greed was good. And now greed is mine. In case I want to upgrade something, being able to roll some life on top of it is nice. And now with essences, yes, they are rare. Yes, they drop randomly, so you have not a lot of control over them. But at least the tier of the mod that you get is fixed. Which of course is slightly different with the beast crafting recipes there. Even if you put in the best beastie ever, it could result in a very low tier. It only fixes the upper tier, not the bottom tier. Okay. Trap it. And have it.
You are well prepared for the end.
And I got myself belt. Immortal flesh. Boatload of life. Decent amount of life regen. Some mana regen, which is of course wasted. Reduced elemental resists. Reduced physical damage taken from attacks. It really does fit in with the whole let's not take any physical damage ever team of the build. Increased armor while not ignited, frozen or shocked. Okay. That basically means most of the time you have a global increase in armor. But of course increased, it stacks with all the other increases. So in practice it's maybe going to be a 10 or 20% more modifier effectively. Because I'm not stacking armor that heavily, I think. Oh, hello porcupine. You want a net? Ah, yes, of course. I'll share with you. There you go.
This one is captured. I now will take it.
And then I think it's good time for a first trip to town. Can I pick up a helmet or something? Yeah, or gloves. That's fine. And then put more stuff in the box. So, and another courthouse. And then we go back. Let's capture my buddies. The dog boss. Oh, another essence. Wow, triple essence. Suffering, sorrow, and torment. Cheerful. Okay. Let's do this. This is gonna be hilarious. Let's just amp up my flasks here and wow, look at the amount of damage I'm taking. You are not kidding around, and then you're dead. Well, it was a pleasure doing business with you. Citadel bow, nice. That is, of course, a euphemism for, yay, more jeweler sockets. Or dual orbs. Okay, still 50 plus mobs. Then again, with large packs like these, that goes quickly. I actually missed the rare that was just charging in to its death. It's one way to avoid capture. Ooh, look at you. I have you.
This one is captured. I now will take it.
Okay, just elemental. Yeah, but this one does not have nemesis mod, so the nemesis theory is out again. Yeah, it's difficult to actually ascertain what the mods are. Hey, Gnar! Okay, so there's no net here, so you are technically not a beastie, I guess. Then Eyepacker is not going to be a beastie either. Nope. Okay. Okay, just throw a bunch of stuff at you. Just to amp you up a little bit. You as well. Cause something in the back of my mind says that they get enraged when their body is gone. So if you just reduce their health by a lot before then, that note might help you actually not having to deal with the enraged version of the boss for too long. Because enraged chicken? It's an angry foe. It's a lot of physical damage, a decent amount of chaos damage from the clouds. It just adds up to a world of hurt. But the chicken is gone. And so are all the other monsters, so... Where is the... Can you... Oh, it's on the right. I thought it was on the left. It used to be on the left, I think, somewhere over here. But, of course, things do get shoveled around. So that also exposes the spider there over there. And there's some shaper stuff coalescing over here. Got two next together. There's three other random splotches. So maybe for next time, Iceberg would be a nice one. I do enjoy the Iceberg map. It's a very fun one to run. But with that, I'm going to thank you very much for watching. And I hope to see you again next episode. Bye-bye.